Good morning, students. Today's topic is nervous system. We are going to see organization and division of the nervous system, functions of nervous system, neuron, neuroglia, nerve fiber, nerve degeneration, regeneration, and denervation hypersensitivity. Nervous system and endocrine system coordinate and direct activities of the body. These two systems react to maintain homeostasis. The difference, what's the difference between nervous system and endocrine system? Nervous system is a rapid, fast acting system whose effects do not always persevere. The endocrine system acts slower and its actions are usually much longer lasting. Functions of nervous system. It consists of sensory input, integration, and motor output. Sensory input carries the sensation with the help of sensory receptors and sent to the integration part, that is nothing but that is sensory input which is present, that is present in the brain and spinal cord, and this send the impulses to the effector organ with the help of motor output. Divisions of nervous system. Nervous system consists of peripheral nervous system, central nervous system. This peripheral nervous system again divided into autonomic nervous system, somatic nervous system. Here, in autonomic nervous system, again divided into sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Somatic nervous system is a nervous system. It is a part of the peripheral nervous system associated with the voluntarily control of the body movements via skeletal muscles. The somatic nerves consist of motor nerve as well as sensory nerve. Now coming to central nervous system. Here central nervous system again divided into brain, spinal cord. Here brain, it's divided into forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Forebrain again divided into telencephalon, diencephalon. Midbrain divided into only one, mesencephalon. Hindbrain divided into metencephalon, myelencephalon. Okay, in forebrain, here telencephalon, diencephalon, this telencephalon contains cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, hippocampus. Diencephalon consists the hypothalamus and thalamus. And metencephalon consists of pons, cerebellum. And myencephalon consists of medulla oblongata. Now, organization of the nervous system. Already we know they are divided into central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system, the brain and the spinal cord, the center of integration and control of all parts of the body. And this peripheral nervous system consists outside of the brain and the spinal cord. It consists of 31 spinal nerves and 12 pairs of cranial nerves. These 13 spinal nerves carry information to and from the spinal cord. And these 12 cranial nerves carry information to and from the brain. Motor efferent division. They are divided into somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Somatic nervous system is a voluntary. The somatic nerve fibers that conduct impulses from the central nervous system to the skeletal muscles. Here in the autonomic nervous system, these are involuntary in movement, and these conduct the impulses from the central nervous system to smooth muscles, cardiac muscles, and glands. Autonomic nervous system is divided into two types, sympathetic and parasympathetic. The autonomic nervous system regulates the operation of internal organs to support the activity of the body as a whole. It is not a separate nervous system, but is an efferent pathway that links those areas within the brain concerned with the regulation of the internal environment to specific effectors such as blood vessels, the heart and gut, and so on. Neuron or the nerve cell is the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. The nervous system of human is made up of innumerable neurons. The neurons are linked together in a highly integrated manner. It is through this connection that the body is made aware of changes in the environment. are of those inside the body itself, and appropriate responses to such changes are produced. Here, nerve cell present in gray matter, dendrites and axon present in white matter. This both this neuron main function is to transmit the electrical signals to other neurons or effector organs. Special features of neurons. It consists of longevity. That is nothing but neuron can live and function for a lifetime. They do not divide in the amniotic fluid. That is, futile neurons lose their ability to undergo mitosis. Neural stem cells are an exception. Okay, and the neurons contain high metabolic rate because it requires abundant oxygen and glucose. Now coming to the parts of the neuron. Cell body. This is the cell body. This is a nucleus. See here. This is the cell body, and this is the nucleus. This is the dendrites, and this is the axon. This is the axon. This is the terminal buttons. This is the terminal buttons. This is the node of Ranvier. Okay, I'll explain one by one. Here, cell body consists of little granules. Cell body of a neuron is also called the soma or perikaryon. Okay, perikaryon. And maybe round, it is look like round, stellate or pyramidal in shape or fusiform in shape. Like any other cell, it consists of a mass of cytoplasm with all its principal constituents surrounded by a cell membrane. The cell body contains a large nucleus with one or two nuclei, but there is no centrosomes. The absence of centrosomes indicates that the neuron has lost ability for division. Thus, neuron once destroyed are replaced by neuroglia only. In addition to the general features of the typical cell, the cytoplasm of the neuron has the following distinctive characteristic. That is, nasal granules. Nasal granules are the basic basophilic granules, seems to be composed of rough surfaced endoplasmic reticulum. The nasal granules, see here, these are the nasal granules. These are the nasal granules. Okay, are present in the dendrites, are well, but are usually absent from axon helix and the axon. Okay, neurofilaments. Neurofilament is also called microfilaments and microtubules. In certain degenerative disease like Alzheimer's disease, the neurofilaments protein gets altered, resulting in the formation of neurofibrillin tangles. Okay, and coming to the most neuron cell body located within the central nervous system, but ganglia, that is clusters of cell bodies that lie along nerves in the peripheral nervous system. Next one is dendrites. Dendrites are very short, multiple in small branch processes. Dendrites contain nasal bodies and neurofibers. Dendrites are also contain receptive processes of the neuron, receiving signals from other neurons via the synapse with axon terminals. It contains nasal granules, mitochondria, neurofibrillary. Impulses can be transmitted from one dendrite to another in the central nervous system. Next one, another one is axon. Axon, it is a long cytoplasmic processor. This is a long cytoplasmic processor capable of propagating of a nerve impulse. Neuron has only one axon. Axon helix is the, this is the axon helix. This is the axon helix, and this is the initial segment which transmit impulse away from the soma. Soma is nothing but cell body. Axon. Axon is a long, single longer process of the nerve cell. It varies in length from a few microns to 1 meter. It arises from the conical extensions of the cell body called axon helix, which is devoid of nasal granules, nasal bodies. The part of the axon between the axon helix and the beginning of myelin sheath is called the initial segment. Initial segment. In the axon, the cell membrane contains as axolemma and the cytoplasm as axoplasm. The axon terminates by dividing into a number of branches and each ending in number of synaptic knobs, also called terminal buttons. See here, this is the terminal buttons. Okay, and synaptic nap contains micro vesicles in which chemical neurotransmitters are stored. Myelin sheath is present around the axon in the so-called myelinated nerve fibers. Myelin sheath, which consists of protein lipid complex, is produced by glial cells called sclerin cells, which encircle the axon, forming around it a thin sleeve. Each sclerin cell provides the myelin sheath for a short segment of the axon. At the junction of any two segments, there is a short gap. This gap are the node of Ranvier's. See here, some gap is there in between two. This is called node of Ranvier. There are some axons which are devoid of myelin sheath. Myelination of axons increases the speed of conduction but greatly increases the diameter. Axons perform the specialized function of conducting impulses away from the cell body. Axon contains neurofilaments, actin, microfilaments and microtubules. This gives the structure of the cell. It provides strength along